Does your party understand climate change? I'm fascinated by your party's response or non-response to the climate strikes on Friday. What did you make of them?
Well, I went to One Gisborne and I talked with young people there. It's very simple. I believe, and I've been an associate climate minister for several years, I believe in climate change. I don't see it as an emergency. I think, firstly, that is unhelpful and worrying. And I think more than that, actually, it is in the absence of action. We all pat ourselves on the back and then we kind of move on. I look at New Zealand, John, and I say, if you look at our emissions profile, there's a lot of complexity, sure, but at one level it's simple. Nearly half of it is food production, primary production, and there are things we could be doing right now, like liberalising our biotechnology rules, and I know you know a bit about that, but I think actually in terms of efficiency and getting our emissions down that area, we should move on that. You then look at the other side of it, and it's transport and energy. Well, in energy, we shouldn't beat ourselves up because we're one of the most renewable countries in the world. But in transport, I've always been abundantly clear about the future for electric vehicles, about the need for incentives in that, and also for public transport. And I've done a huge amount as Transport Minister in that regard.
And yet you strongly oppose the government's new policy announcements on electric vehicles. When you say you don't think climate change is an emergency, IPCC...
But come on, John, you can't say that and then move on. I'm sorry, you just can't. That's because I don't accept a car tax when you've got people doing it rough, when they're sleeping rough, when they're paying rent that's gone up higher and faster than ever, when they're feeling it at the pump and petrol taxes. These are families that can ill afford that sort of $3,000 tax when they can't just move to a Tesla because they can't afford it.
So if you believe in electric cars and if you believe we need to respond to climate change, what is your most effective and appealing policy to the climate strikers on Friday that tells them you are taking this seriously?
I think in agriculture, it's biotech rules that the government won't move on. I think in electric vehicles, we've already made clear we will transform the government fleet, which is a big deal. There's 15,000 vehicles that then become second-hand vehicles in our market to electric. And I also believe in incentives, because I think the truth is, if you look at government, if you're not wasting money on Shane Jones and fees freeze, you can do quite a bit in that area, and it doesn't have to hit and hurt hard-working Kiwis in their back pocket.
You retweeted an op-ed in the New Zealand Herald, which had the headline, "It's time to take a step back on climate change." It was written by a young woman who called the climate strikes complete ridiculousness, the result of brainwashing. She used that phrase twice, and she compared what she called the bandwagon of the climate change protest movement with wearing Nike slides. Why did you retweet that?
Because I wanted to show solidarity to her. She is someone from a farming family. She is standing out from the crowd. And actually, I don't believe
she right?
in the hysteria climate emergency.
I'm sorry to interrupt. You don't believe the hysteria around the climate emergency?
No, I don't. I believe in climate change. I believe we need sensible, practical actions. I don't see any of that from the government, by the way. You had a nice interview with her yesterday morning where ultimately the Prime Minister didn't come up with a single thing that they have done. At the UN, she talked about all these things. They haven't done any of them other than actually the oil and gas ban, which has seen emissions going up. So I say, you know what we need in New Zealand? We need just those sensible, practical policies that move the dial. Not the big talk, not the marches where people go home and pat themselves on the back, but nothing actually changes.
Simon Bridges joining us live from his electorate office in Tauranga. Thank you very much indeed for your time. We really appreciate it.